Okay, in this video, we're going to take a look at the difference between free and bound ribosomes. So you've heard of ribosomes. You can identify them in any diagram of a cell. They look like the little bits of pepper that are speckled around a cell. If you're going to draw one, you're going to think pepper, so you're going to put a bunch of dots. Prokaryotic cells have them. Eukaryotic cells have them. If you're a nerd, then you know that prokaryotic ones are 70S size and eukaryotic ones are 80S size. And the S, if you're a bigger nerd, you'll know what the S stands for. And it actually stands for Svedberg units. It's a way to measure the size of ribosomes. But here, we're to talk about the difference between free and bound ribosomes. So try to find out what in the world these bound and free ribosomes are. See if you can locate them on this particular diagram. Okay, successful? Yes. Then you should know that these little dots here are bound, or they're connected to the actual endoplasmic reticulum, which makes it rough. Rough ER, or rough endoplasmic reticulum, try saying that really fast, actually has ribosomes that are connected to it. But some of these ribosomes are floating around. They are the free ones, and the ones that are connected to the ER are called the bound ones. The basic difference is very simple. Those ribosomes that are out here, the free floating ones, tend to be making proteins for use within the cell. And those ribosomes that are bound tend to be making proteins that are ready to be packaged into vesicles to be secreted or moved outside of the actual cell by exocytosis. That's basically it. So one more quick reminder, free ribosomes synthesize proteins primarily for use within the cell, whereas the bound ribosomes, they're attached to the ER, and the ER can pinch off and create these vesicles. It can also move some of these products of translation to the Golgi apparatus, where they can be packaged further into a vesicle and then moved out by exocytosis. So the fact that it's already, the ribosomes that are already attached to the ER are already very easily packaged into vesicles can give you a little clue that the ones that are close to this place can actually be delivered a lot easier because they can be put into these little packages. So bound ribosomes synthesize proteins for export or secretion from the cell or for use in the lysosomes. And for use inside the lysosomes, you're also packaging them inside vesicles. So that's going to help speed up that process. So that's basically it. Quick and dirty distinction between free and bound ribosomes.